Look at this! It finally arrived! The package where I was waiting such a long time for. So, let's read the description of this packet from Hong Kong. So, what's inside of here? Quantity and details descriptions of contents. And they wrote down rubber sheet. Why do you need a rubber sheet in your server rack? And the value is $10. My name is Victor Bart and welcome by Retro Machines. So what can this package be? So let's open it. We have a plastic box. So good protection for what's inside of this. So let's take this out. And here we have two packs of thermal compound. But I don't gonna use that. So here. Here we have it. I was waiting so long for this. Two CPUs for the Supermicro server. Yes! And they are 6 cores. They are Xeon L5640s. They run at 2.26 GHz. So we will have 12 cores with hyperthreading in the server. And these are L CPUs, so they are like the low power versions and they are 60 watt each. So let's install them in the Supermicro server and upgrade the memory, install the storage and make my backup server out of it. It took over 2 months to deliver these CPUs to me because the first package was lost and these are the second set of CPUs that they sent to me and I paid $18.50 for the two CPUs with shipping. I put down the feet of the server rack because we're gonna move this Supermicro rack out of the server rack on its rails. So we can work on the server rack without removing it from the whole rack. So we can simply take off the cover and let's remove the air duct. And right now we have one CPU installed and it is a 4-core. I think it's running at 2.2 GHz or something, but no second CPU. And we have 3 16 GB sticks right now. And we're gonna install another set of 16 GB here. And of course the second CPU. If you want to know more about the server, I have another video that I already made. And there I tell you how I found this in a dumpster. And I do the initial overview of this system. So you should also watch that video. Because I think after the upgrades that I'm gonna do today, this will be a really powerful machine from a dumpster. And the purpose of this machine will be my backup server. In the front there will be 10 3 terabyte hard drives. And I will make backups of my main server that is here. And this Supermicro server is a dual socket 1366. So I need a second cooler, but luckily I have this brand new socket 1366 coolers. And they are exactly the models that I need for this machine. As you can see, they are both NSKP003HPs. But this is Revision A and I'm gonna install those. And this is Revision B with copper heat pipes. But probably with L CPUs, this will be more than enough. And there's already thermal paste installed, but I'm gonna remove that. Because I'm gonna install some Noctua NT-H2 and Noctua was so kind to provide me this big tube. So the coolers are clean, so now let's apply the thermal paste. And these CPUs are a little bit bigger than normal CPUs, so only a drop in the middle is not enough. And if you go even bigger CPUs, like more modern Xeons or like an Epic, you need to apply even more. So we're gonna start with a drop in the middle and then like 4 dots around it. So let's directly install some more memory. So we have Hynix 16 GB quad ranked memory. running at 1066. So it's not the fastest memory, but sticks like this are really cheap. So I got 96 gigabyte memory for 105 euros.
And that's pretty cheap.
And this server won't be a silent server. This is taking way too long. Normally a server will take some time to boot, but this is way too long. I think I made a mistake. I didn't update the BIOS before swapping the CPUs. But I'm gonna do the BIOS update and the CPU swapping off camera. Otherwise this video will be an hour long and really boring with swapping CPUs. And as you can see, BIOS 1.0b. Whoops, let's update the BIOS. Now we have BIOS 2.1c from 2012, so time to reinstall the CPUs and test it again, because now we probably have support for the CPUs. And the current CPU is an E5520 running at 2266 MHz. So the two L5640s are installed. They are also running at 2266 MHz, but now we have two CPUs instead of one, and instead of four cores, we have 12 cores with hyper-threading and also 96 gigabyte memory installed. Let's work on the expansion cards. I gonna install two cards and also some blanks for the slots we don't use. To get the correct airflow, you need to have rear covers with holes in it. And I didn't have one for here, so I made my own holes in this bracket. We're gonna install two expansion cards, an IBM 1015 with two SAS connectors, so I can connect 8 devices on this card, and this Kyocera 10 gigabit SFP plus network card. But we don't need the active cooling on this card, because we have a lot of airflow in this server. So I can remove this little Noctua fan. But if you use a card like this in your workstation with less airflow over your PCI cards, you can better have some active cooling, because cards like this can get really hot. And in this 2U server we have 4 PCIe 8x slots. Here in the front I have 10 SATA hard drives from 3TB each. And they are hot swappable now on this backplane. But this backplane really sucks, because it has a port per drive instead of just a big SAS connector. So I have luckily the right cables already here in the chassis, but I only have a 2-port SAS controller, so I can only have 8 drives from here to the SAS controller. So 4 drive base of this chassis needs to go to the SATA ports here on the motherboard. So let's remove the cable from the upper backplane and use SATA cables there and connect the cables to the IBM. Oh no, they made a really big mess of the cabling, because it's not a cable per backplane, but a cable per random backplane. So here we have the backplane, and they numbered from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, yeah, why not just 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. I'm gonna just rewire it how I like it instead of this. Cabling doesn't go how I want it, because the cables are too short. I will do this just off camera, that will take just too long. So all the cabling is in, and I put it back in the Super Micro configuration, because the red wires were too short, and there was first an Areca card in here with the connectors here, and then it was no problem, but I just used the cards as an HBA with ZFS, so the Areca is not working for that. So this solution will work, and the cables are nice and tight like this. And the two blue cables here goes from the motherboard via this route to drive base here, and I can put two extra SATA cables in here if I need to, if I want to use all the drive bays. Let's rearrange the hard drives. I have four Western Digital Reds. So this is now channel 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm gonna put the Reds in those channels. I have 5 Seagate Barracudas. So let's fill the rest of the chassis up. And the final drive is a 3 TB HGST. And that goes together with a Barracuda on the SATA controller on the motherboard. Okay, the two hard drives on the SATA controllers on the motherboard are detected. The Chelsea is working. That's a 10 gig network card. And here we have the LSI SAS BIOS. So let's see if it detects all the drives. The Seagates are detected. And the Western Digitals weren't showing up. Okay, this connector was loose. That's why the Western Digitals weren't showing up. All the hard drives are now detected. 4 Seagate, 4 Western Digital, all 3 TB. So the operating system that I'm gonna install is FreeNAS. To be honest, I'm not the biggest fan of FreeNAS in the past. So I will try it out if it works for me. And I put in here 2 USB sticks of 8 GB each. And here I have a USB stick with insulation. But one disadvantage of this machine, that it has only 2 USB ports inside and 2 outside. So with the keyboard also, we have now all the USB ports filled. Let's install FreeNAS 11.2. Select one or more drives where FreeNAS should be installed. Use arrows to navigate the drives. So let's see, we have all the hard drives here. And we have here 2 USB sticks that we're gonna select because we want to install it on a mirrored USB set. I'm not sure why, but the FreeNAS installation has failed. So, what's wrong with this FreeNAS and this server? So it's a few days later now. I had some issues with installing FreeNAS on this server. It turned out that my install USB stick was not working properly and was giving errors. Also, I replaced the 2 USB sticks on the motherboard with 16 GB USB sticks, also in the mirror. And I first had to make them clean under Windows, removing all the partitions. Otherwise, FreeNAS was giving errors, but now it's running great, so let's make the 10 disk RAID set 2. So let's log into FreeNAS with root and your password. So we have quite an overkill on CPU power, 2 Intel Xeons, total 24 cores, 96 GB. And if we go to storage and then pools, we can add the pool. Let's create a new pool. And here we see all the hard drives. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 hard drives, all the drives are detected. So let's select them all. And let's make a RAID set 2, that is like RAID 6. So 2 disks can fail before I lose my data. And these are older hard drives, so RAID set 2 is the best solution for it. Also, I have 10 hard drives and that is perfect for 4K sectors. So here we can give the pool a name. Let's call it backup. And then we click create. And the total raw storage is 21.82 TB because we have 10 3 TB hard drives in this system. So we have 20 TB free space. And to check if the 4K sectors are working, you go to the shell and you do setdb minus u data setfs setpool cache more. And here you can see it is running ZFS version 5000, name backup. RAID set 2 with two parities and the A-shift 12, and that is 4K sectors. And if it says A-shift 9, it's the older 512 sector system. So if we go back to the dashboard, we see here that the pool is healthy and all the drives that are used, and also information about the memory usage, CPU usage, CPU temperatures, load average. So I'm probably gonna tune the memory that ZFS just eats up all the memory in this system, because ZFS loves memory, and just build a system with enough memory for it. And don't say, oh, ZFS is using too much memory. Just get a box with a lot of memory. And with DDR3 server memory, it's not that expensive. And here you can make accounts and the sharing, and I don't gonna configure my server right now. And also you can make some virtual machines. So maybe I gonna experiment with making a virtual machine on this box, because we have enough resources on this system. So here you have it, the build of my Supermicro backup server. I found this chassis in a dumpster. I upgraded the CPUs to 2.6 cores. A lot of memory in it, 96 gigabyte, 10 3TB hard drives in a RAID set 2, an IBM M1015 SAS controller, a Chelsea 10 gigabit network card, which really helps with making backups over the network. And what I really love about this system, that is the rail kit. So it was really easy to work on this system, and I can simply slide it in and out. So yeah, really nice to have the rail kit with this machine. The cooling is not silent, but the sound level is not that extreme, so I can make my backups in daytime without any issues here in the home. But at night I will turn this system off, because it's a bit too loud. My file server is running great now, with the server rack on the other side of the room. Even with my door open of this room, the sound level in the house is really minimum. So I can run that 24 hours a day without any issues in terms of sound. Thanks for watching. And if you'd like to know more about my home rack or my main server, you can check out my videos, and I also made a playlist for it. So please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook and support me monthly on Patreon, so I can buy CPUs like this. And of course you can also use my Amazon affiliated links and follow me on Twitter.
Did you see it? They said it was hauled from the Challenger Deep, but I'm positive that beast never swam in terrestrial waters until a week ago. There's a tranquilizer gun in the shark cage, but I'm not sure it would work on this species. You're welcome to try.